Pankaj Tile, and welcome to Tibet This Week. This is Sakina Bhatt with another edition of Weekly News on Tibet, His Holiness the Dalai Lama and Central Tibetan Administration. Let's look at the headlines. His Holiness the Dalai Lama in conversation with Gaur Gopal Das. A right and a timely message to China, says CTA President on US sanctions. Historic milestone, 19 students to receive the prestigious Sik Yong Scholarship this year. Tibetans urge United Nations to release Anya Sendra. Virtual side event on human rights situation in Tibet. Italian MP Bianchi raises concern over China's continued human rights violations. Former Tibetan political prisoner Samduk passes away at the age of 50 in Tibet. His Holiness the Dalai Lama had a video conversation with Gaur Gopal Das, a former Hewlett-Packard engineer who is now a monk belonging to the International Society for Krishna Consciousness on Tuesday this week. Emphasizing on the importance of ahimsa and karuna, he said that these qualities are being neglected in today's world.
So Buddha learned already sort of existing spiritual tradition in India. That is Jainism and also, you see, Sangha philosophy in these different sort of Indian philosophy, all carry the concept of ahimsa, karuna.
President Dr. Lobsang Singye welcomed the United States sanctions on senior officials of the Chinese Communist Party and called the act a right action and timely message to China by the US government. On Thursday last week, the United States imposed sanctions on three senior officials of the Chinese Communist Party, including Ken Chuango, Party Secretary of the Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region and member of Politburo, for involvement in gross human rights violations against Uyghurs and other minorities in Xinjiang, also known as East Turkestan. Just a day earlier, the US Department of State had announced visa bans against Chinese government officials deemed responsible for barring foreigners' access to Tibet. For the first time ever in the history of Tibetan Children's Class 12 Board Examination, 19 Tibetan students have achieved 95% and above. The students will be receiving Sik Yong Scholarship of Rs. 1 lakh each. Central Board of Secondary Education, Delhi, has declared the results for Class 12th Examinations 2020 on Monday this week. CTA President Dr. Lobsang Singye congratulated the students, CTA's Department of Education, the teachers and the parents for their collective support regarding the achievement.
This scholarship has proven that if you reward excellence, people will perform and live up to the expectation. So this is a major achievement. And yesterday, at the initial news of NDTV, Rwala, and the school was listed Jawaharlal Nehru Rwa School, and then the Kendra Vidyalaya and the CTSA was listed as the third highest ranking pass percentage. So this year we have like 98.7% passing class 12 performance.
It is all because of hard work, consistency and effort put by my all teachers. So I would like to thank to all the staff of THF, including both teaching and non-teaching staff, for their continuous support and blessing on us. Being a Tibetan, especially I would like to thank to His Holiness for His blessing on us. Thank you.
One thing I would like to share to my younger ones is that the fundamental unit of studying is listening, reading and writing. I repeat, listening, reading and writing.
CTA Special Appointee for Human Rights, Ms. Tinley Chuki at Tibet Bureau Geneva, urged the United Nations to raise voice against the triad of collusion by the Chinese state authorities, Chinese police and Chinese judiciary to permit and enable misappropriation of Tibetans' lands for Belt and Road Initiative and such other so-called development projects. Ms. Chuki appealed the UN Human Rights Council and member states to press China to release Anya Sendra and other Tibetan human rights defenders. The Tibet Bureau Geneva had a virtual side event titled Human Rights Situation in Tibet on Wednesday this week. The panelists, Sophie Richardson, China Director of Human Rights Watch, Krista Meinders-Ma, Advocacy Director at International Campaign for Tibet, Netherlands, and Tenzing Ladhu, a visiting fellow at Tibet Policy Institute, CTA.
Very quickly, I want to mention something that Tinley just referenced about the extraordinary call from the special procedures about 2 weeks ago, because not only did it set out all of the different human rights violations that we're grappling with, but it also highlighted China's unwillingness to cooperate with the UN human rights system.
I think Tibet is a case in point. The Chinese government used its campaign against the virus as an excuse to step up its repression of Tibetans in the name of maintaining stability.
In China, when we talk about government, state, nation, and so-called motherland, it has been all understood as a homogeneous entity.
A member of Italian Parliament, Mr. Matteo Lunghi Bianchi, voiced concern over China's continued violation of international human rights obligation in Italian Parliament on Thursday last week. MP Bianchi said that international communities cannot afford to keep pretending and urged that Western countries can no longer remain silent in the face of Chinese bullying and repression against the Tibetan people. A former Tibetan political prisoner, Samdo from Changra Township, Pempo County, passed away at the age of 50 in Tibetan Autonomous Region. Samdo suffered from diabetes and was admitted into Lhasa Public Hospital early this year and took his last breath on February 17th. Samdo was sentenced to 3 years in prison for staging a peaceful protest with 15 other monks on May 12, 1992 in Lhasa. After he served his initial 3 years, he was again imprisoned for another 4 years for unknown reasons. So much for today. See you next time and have a great weekend.